Well, it's Prostate Cancer Awareness Month. You know, the disease is the second most common cancer among men in our country, but it can often be treated successfully. Turns out that 1 in 7 men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer in their lifetime. That means over 150,000 cases are estimated this year. But sadly, more than 25,000 of those are likely to be fatal. So how do you detect it and stop that? Dr. David Samadi, he's back. He's with us now to find out more, our former partner on Sunday House Call. Great to see you again,
nice
David.
Nice to see you again, Eric.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
So what should men know, and those who love men know, about prostate cancer, detecting it and treating it?
Well, I think everyone is questioning whether they should go for screening or not. And I think there has been a lot of debate about this test, PSA. A few years ago, there were some studies that confused everyone that maybe this test is not as good as we thought it is. And this week, we had a big study that came out of Annals of Internal Medicine saying that finally, PSA can reduce the risk of death by 30%, 25 to 32%. This is a great study because it takes a lot of confusion out. And people need to know that the PSA test, while it's not very accurate, we look at the trend and the speed of the rise, and in the hands of expert surgeon, we can really save your life and reduce the risk of death. That's really important. Today, not only we have the PSA test, we also have a lot of imaging studies such as MRIs. We had one of the first MRI fusion biopsies. These are targeted biopsies that we specifically look for lesions, and we can find the cancer early. The nice thing about prostate cancer is that when it's caught early on, Eric, and you have absolutely no symptoms, and without screening, you won't be able to find this. But when it's caught early on, the risk of death is much reduced, complications are lower, and people can go back to their life in really good quality of life.
What is a is there such a thing as a normal PSA number? I mean, it is depend upon your age. It depends upon how large the prostate is.
Typically,
what we know?
Yeah, typically we say that it should be less than 4, and that's the number to remember. But it's also age specific. So when I see someone at the age of 40 in my office, I look for PSA around 1.5, and I also look at that PSA to see what it does over the years. If it really jumps to go from 1.5 to 3 to 6, I would be very concerned about this patient, and I would basically recommend him to get a biopsy. So I think people, men out there that are at higher risk, African Americans, because we know that race plays a big role. If your first degree family member has prostate cancer, you need to be checked. And obviously, aging is one of the risk factors. So if you fall into those categories, start getting your PSA at the age of 40 as a baseline, and then have conversation with your doctor and make sure that you really know what's going on.
Where can people go find out who are watching right now, if you're watching and you're concerned, to get more information on this?
Well, for month of September, for a lot of men that are diagnosed with prostate cancer, you're told this week that you have prostate cancer, you're confused whether you should go for surgery or radiation. You can go to prostatecancer911.com, and we're offering our free advice to make sure. You know, with surgery, we can cure a lot of people. They get the cancer out, they know PSA should be 0, they have the option of radiation after surgery. A lot of people don't know that if they go for radiation or cyberknife or other treatments, if the cancer recurs, surgery would be very difficult. So all these questions, you can come to prostatecancer911.com, and there are a lot of other surgeons in other states that we would refer you to and be able to take care of you.
Well, that's a great help, and it's a great public service. You know, certainly something that us men, you know, all share, especially if the folks who love us take care of that prostate.
Absolutely. And I know you're a great advocate. I'm glad we've been able to keep you healthy all these years.
Yeah, we have.
Good to see you on a Sunday
you
as well.
You too. Good to see you back with us.
Thank you.
David Samadi, of course.